You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
So now I'm going to do some manual keyframing. I'm going to disable the visibility on the upper short here so we can see our lower shape a little bit better. I'm going to zoom in. So I'm going to just scrub through the timeline and I'm going to look at when the shape changes a lot. So we go from a lot of wrinkles here to almost none here. And I could make a keyframe here, but what I'm really going to do is make a keyframe where I still see some wrinkles. If I go too far and I make a straight shape here, then I might lose track of where the low points and the high points are for the wrinkles on the side. So probably go maybe about to here, and I'm going to click T. I'm going to move my shape. Do some editing. With a shape that moves this much on the side, we're going to have to do some point moving as well. And then I'll make sure that my points are staying roughly in the same area. Shift X to the next keyframe and Shift Z to go to the previous keyframe. If for some reason your points don't stay in the same place, you can get something that's called rippling. So for example, if you shift all of these points here, let's just select the whole shape. And if we move things down too far, and then you can see that this section here is actually moved. And then you get rippling. We have points just ripple across the edge of the shape. So we'll just delete this keyframe. I'm going to select the keyframe inside the timeline and hit delete. So, but when I'm still looking at this shape, it's still a very complex shape. And I have to go back and possibly make some more edits here. It's not quite perfect. Go into points mode, click the R key. This lower section moves a lot differently from this middle section and from this top section up here. So I do some more edits to make sure that my line is exactly where it's supposed to be. My points are staying in the same location between keyframes. It's quite a lot of work. It's almost like three different shapes. But Silhouette has another option to help you out here as well, and that's called point groups. So I will just finish this edit here and we'll make some point groups. And point groups are just what they say they are. They're groups of points that help for fast selecting. And let's zoom in here or zoom out. I'm going to select the three different areas that I want to have as a point group. And you can have up to eight. So I'm going to select this lower area here. I'm going to right click. And I'm going to make a group, and that's going to be group one. And then I'm going to select my middle area here. And that's going to be group two. And then I'm going to select this upper area here. And that's going to be group three. And the hotkeys to select the different groups are Alt 1, Alt 2, and Alt 3. So Alt 1, you see I'm selected for the lower group. Alt 2 is the middle group, and Alt 3 is the upper group. And you can change some things in the preferences to make the visibility a little bit easier. Bring up the preferences and we'll go to color, and you can see here point groups. We can edit that. So our point group one is going to be yellow, and then two is green, and three is blue. You could change that. We'll just go okay. And then we're going to select how thick the line is where the point group is selected. And that's going to be in the shape preference. You can see here point group line width, and that's set at 4. So we'll just put that 5 a little bit bigger. We'll click apply and okay. I think our spline is very large for the course, so it's harder to see because we're already at a pretty large thickness here, but we could make it even thicker. Let's do that. Just for demonstration purposes, we're going to go to, let's try 8. And we'll click apply and go okay. And now you can see our line a little bit better. So I'll zoom out. So Alt 1, Alt 2, and Alt 3. So now when I edit my shape, if I go to a different frame, and it's all moving a little bit differently, I can see that this lower area here is moving different. I just click Alt 1 and I can just move this section very fast. Alt 2, let's just move this out here with the arrow keys. We can still just select points individually. And then Alt 3. To recap and finish up here, there are two ways to make point groups. I'll make a demo shape here to help illustrate. Either select a range of points on a spline and right-click and choose groups and one, or you can select a group of points and click Shift plus Alt 1 through 8. So I'll select these points over here. I'll hold down Shift and Alt and 2, since I already have a point group with 1. And now you can see I have 2 point groups. If I go to select other points to make another point group and right click, you can see that existing point groups have a line under them. So I'll call this one 3. I'll select 3. And now I have 3 point groups. And once I've defined my point groups, I can use the hotkey combo of Alt 1 through 8 to select them. Alt 1, I have this group selected. Alt 2, I have this group selected. And Alt 3, this group. Alternatively, another way to select a group is to click Control Command plus Shift and click on the spline within a grouped area. So if I just deselect here and I hold down, for me it's Command and Shift, and click on the spline, then you can see my point group is selected. And then if it's hard to differentiate between the colors of the groups, that can be changed too. Just go to the color section in preferences, and you can define your point group colors here. So if I want this to be maybe a different color, just click on that. It'll bring up a color picker. We'll just choose blue for this one. For 2, we'll make this magenta. Click OK. And 3, we'll choose purple. Okay, so now we can go back, click apply, OK. And we have our new colors here. We zoom in a little bit, you can see them better. So Alt 1, Alt 2, and Alt 3. So that's a wrap on point groups. It's a really great roto feature for fast selection, which means faster editing. Let's take a look at the roto final and the screen right upper short that we've been focusing on. So here my roto node, you can see that my screen right leg all. I've grouped all of the shapes for the screen right leg into layers for the screen right leg. And let's find this screen right lower short. And you can see I have no tracking data applied to my layer. It's just all manual keyframing. And for the screen right upper short, we'll click on that shape here. I was able to use some tracking for that, some planar tracking. You can see this. Let me just bring up the sash. And we'll find this layer in here. The screen right upper short, you can see I have transform data inside this layer, but I still had to make keyframes on top of the tracking data. Organic shapes can be difficult to track. There's lots of keyframes. And while this clip required a lot of manual articulated roto, it's not a negative thing. It provides plenty of opportunities to familiarize oneself with Silhouette's editing tools and for an artist to learn the art of rotoscoping. Okay, next up I will demo with some point tracking, and we will tackle these wires over here on screen left.